Yes, I could have been a judge, but I never had the Latin. I just never had the Latin for the judging. I just never had it, so I'd had it as far as being a judge was concerned. I hadn't got enough of it to get through the rigorous judging exams. They're very rigorous, the judging exams. Very rigorous indeed. They're noted for their rigour. People come out of them saying, my God, what a rigorous exam. And so I become a miner instead. I managed to get through the mining exams. They're not very rigorous. There's no rigour involved, really. There's complete lack of rigour involved in the mining exams. They only ask you one question. They say, who are you? And I got 75% on that. I was allowed right down. Of course, it's quite interesting work, getting hold of lumps of coal all day. It's quite interesting. You're given complete freedom to do what you like, absolute free hand to do anything you like, provided you get hold of 2 tons of coal every day. But the method you do it, you can use any method open to you. Hacking and hewing is a normal one. Some people prefer the hacking, others the hewing. Some people do the combination. I'm a combination man myself. I do the hack and hew, both. And then there's running at the coal face with your head. That's another one of the worst methods, known as the bad method of getting hold of coal. Then there's scrabbling at it with your bare hands. It's the almost as bad method of getting hold of coal. And there's a myriad others, but hacking and hewing, as you say, it's quite a varied life you have down there. The trouble with it is the people. I'm not saying you get a load of riffraff down the mine, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying we had a load of riffraff down my mine. Very boring conversationalists. Extremely boring. All they talk about is what goes on in the mine. Extremely boring. If you're searching for a word to describe the conversations, what go on down the mine, boring would spring to your... It would spring to your lips. They go on and on with these... Oh, God, they're very boring. If ever you want to hear a boring conversation, just pop down the mine. There it will be. Things like, hello, I found a bit of coal. Have you really? Yes, no doubt about it. This black substance is coal, all right. Jolly good, the very thing we're looking for. Yes, and what's more, it's quite a heavy lump. Be very careful not to drop it on your foot then. Ha ha ha. What? Me drop a great heavy lump of coal on my foot? You must be out of your... Oh! I've dropped it on my foot, I see. Silly duffer. Yes. Hello, I found another lump of coal. Even heavier than the first lump. Be very careful not to drop that on your foot then. Ha ha ha. What? Me drop another great heavy lump of coal on my foot? You must be out of your... Oh! I've dropped it on your foot, I see. It's not enough to keep the mind alive, is it? I sought solace in the printed page, quite frankly, for I'm very interested in the world of literature. It's a wonderful book of myths, what I read. It's a very accurate portrayal of what didn't happen many millions of years ago. An interpretation, it tells about the wonderful story of Theseus trailing out golden string behind him. They used to trail it out behind him, always behind, never in front, trailing it out. People used to remark on it. As soon as he went by, they said, there's old Theseus, trailing out his golden string, I see. And the cry used to be taken up by the villagers. Yes, that's Theseus, all right. You can tell him by the golden string what he's trailing about behind him. I should think he's off somewhere important with all that golden string training out. But anyway, he come upon the labyrinth wherein dwelt the minnow. The ghastly one-eyed minnow. What lay stark naked on the rock and sung its haunting songs. It had others, but mainly it sung its haunting ones. They were the most requested, the haunting ones. The mariners passing by an argators used to hear the mystic singing trailing across the ocean. I am the minnow. And as soon as they heard it, they would leap overboard onto the jagged rocks below. Wrongly. For they were playing into the minnow's hands. That's just what the minnow wanted. It's the last thing the mariners ought to have done. And incidentally, it was the last thing the mariners ever did. Anyway, Theseus waxed wrathful and crept up on it in the cool of the evening and strangled it with a golden string of Damocles, what he'd been trailing about behind him for that very purpose, and it never troubled man or beast again. But the trouble is that all this knowledge I've got hold of is useless. Useless as regards the judging. They require the Latin for it. I wish I'd had it, because it's safer work judging than mining. You're not troubled by falling coal, for one thing. You don't get that down your guild halls. It's a feature of your guild hall life. The absence of falling coal. You get judges remarking on it. They say, hello, not much coal falling in today. And what's more, being a miner, as soon as you're too old and tired and ill and sick and stupid to do your job properly, you have to go. Well, the very opposite applies with the judges. So all in all, I'd rather have been a judge than a miner.